Hello, my name is Tim Stapko. I'm a senior software engineer at Microsoft. I work on Azure RTOS and other microcontroller things. And today we're going to be talking about the offering that we built along with STMicroelectronics. It's based on the STU5, which is a new ultra low power microcontroller device that's designed specifically for IoT. I'm going to be talking about the security and RTOS applications that can be built using that device. Before we dig into the specifics of the hardware and software, we'll get a sort of an overview here of how all of this fits together. The STU5 is a new microcontroller device based on an ARM Cortex M33. And in this scenario, it's going to be running Azure RTOS, which includes real-time operating system, connectivity stack, and it's also going to be running the Azure IoT Devices SDK, which enables the connectivity and features that you can leverage using the Azure IoT Cloud services. All of this is tied together by Azure IoT Central, which enables you to develop applications to visualize your data and control your fleet of devices. So looking at the hardware first, this is the STM32U5. It's a microcontroller device with enhanced security features based on an ARM Cortex M33 with TrustZone. It has built-in cryptographic acceleration for AES, EEC, and hashing. It's got a hardware unique key for data protection. It's got some hardware tamper detection monitoring. And the hardware itself is actually certified both by PSA, which is ARM's security certification, and SESIP. Paired with the U5 on the Discovery Kit device is the ST Safe A110, a hardware security module that enables a true hardware root of trust. It has a pairing key for bus encryption to protect data physically on the device. It's got cryptographic acceleration and handling in hardware to protect your private keys. It's got protected memory so that your key data never actually leaves the hardware. And sort of most importantly for IoT, it has a factory installed X509 device certificate, which can be utilized by IoT Hub and Azure to uniquely identify your device in the cloud. So digging into the security features of the U5, we have TrustZone. TrustZone is an ARM technology, which is essentially a secure partitioning scheme. It allows for hardware enforced boundaries between your secure and non-secure applications. And enhances the security of other features, such as monitoring of peripherals, monitoring of the device, hardware drivers, etc. TrustZone by itself is just the partitioning scheme, so you need some way to be able to utilize those services effectively. TFM is a reference implementation of ARM's PSA APIs, and essentially provides a secure kernel for microcontroller devices. It enables such services as cryptography, root of trust, protected storage, firmware update, and secure boot. And specifically on the U5, the implementation of TFM that ST provides also integrates with that ST Safe hardware security module so that you have that true hardware root of trust. So now digging into the Azure RTOS security features, as mentioned before, Azure RTOS is a complete microcontroller stack within real-time operating system called ThreadX, a TCP/IP stack called NetX Duo. Running on top of NetX Duo is NetX Duo Secure TLS, which is a complete TLS stack with a cryptography library. The cryptography library is both software implementations of popular algorithms, but also there's an abstraction layer that enables us to integrate with TFM and the ST Safe part on the U5 device, enabling us to tap into that hardware security that we were just discussing. Riding on top of TLS is the NetX Duo MQTT client and the embedded C IoT SDKs from Microsoft that enable you to connect to the Azure Cloud services, specifically the IoT endpoints, and also enables, there's a couple of different lightweight agents for device update and Azure Defender, which we're gonna talk about in a moment. So now you have your device all set up and ready to go, and you wanna connect it to Azure and do some some cloud things. So to connect a microcontroller device to Azure, you're going to be using Azure IoT Hub. By itself, IoT Hub has support for some basic security. It utilizes TLS. You can use a SAS token, which is essentially a pre-shared key, or you can use a certificate. Now, in our case, with the U5, we can utilize that X509 certificate that is baked into the ST Safe device from the factory with a private key that's never exposed anywhere. So you have that true hardware root of trust. And you're going to be able to connect that microcontroller running Azure RTOS through device provisioning service to Azure Hub, IoT Hub. DPS is going to enable you to assign your devices to specific hubs and do a few other things. And then Hub itself is going to enable you to actually collect telemetry and do control plane operations for your fleet of devices. Additionally, the Azure Defender for IoT framework is running in tandem with IoT Hub and utilizing the agent that's within the Azure RTOS stack running on your microcontroller. So all of this is integrated together to enable you to securely connect your U5 application to Azure, collect telemetry, send control data, update the firmware, anything else that you might want to do for an IoT type device. Okay, so now that we've seen the full stack from end to end, we're going to take a look at the actual hardware here. So what we've got here is an end-to-end IoT solution utilizing the U5 hardware and Azure RTOS. The kit itself enables you to easily connect your device through to IoT Central, where you're going to be able to visualize real sensor data coming from the device. And it's going to be secured using TFM and the Azure RTOS security features that we talked about. With Azure IoT Plug and Play, your U5 device is already modeled and will be recognized by Azure when it connects. So all of your sensor data will be easily picked up and will allow you to build an application very rapidly within IoT Central to visualize that data. You can get started with the U5 today. First of all, you're going to need to get your hardware. Then you're going to need to configure and build the app that's going to go onto your device. You're going to need to create a free Azure IoT Central application. And boom, your data will be visualized. All of this is done through the Quick Connect guide that comes with the kit. And there's a script that is basically no code, low touch. You're going to have to enter a few things like Wi-Fi credentials. But in a few easy steps, you'll be up and running with your IoT Central application. Thank you for listening.